Have you ever asked yourself what real happiness is in life and how you can attain it? Well, in this video I'm going to break the myth of what happiness is, what it is not, and how you can actually attain it right now. That's what's coming up right now. Hi and welcome back to the Conscious Leaders TV. I'm Yannick Matzner. I'm your leadership and business coach. I'm the founder of the Conscious Leaders Mastermind. And here on this channel, I mentor you every single day to be a great leader and go after the life you truly want. But if you're not subscribed, you're not seeing my videos, and I can't mentor you. So go ahead, do that right now. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. Now let's jump into this episode. So, what is real happiness? I mean, we all want to be happy in life, that's no question, but what is real happiness? We still have a very fake image of what real happiness is, and so many people still believe that they can be happy once they attain this and that, once they got that money, once they got that promotion, once they got that thing in their lives, that's when I'll be happy. But that never works because, yeah, you feel happy in the moment, like for 2 minutes, then it's gone and you feel like empty again because you have nothing to show for it. So real happiness is not like an end result. It is not something that you need to chase, because if you need to chase something, it implies that that thing is running away from you. I mean, if you need to chase happiness, it implies that your happiness is running away from you. And that's not what we want. I mean, we might catch it someday, but why not feel happy right now? That's a real question, because real happiness is an emotional state. It is something that you can feel right now. And here's what I suppose. Real happiness equals fulfillment. It is not that fake happiness that you want to have in your life. It is that feeling of, yeah, I'm doing something great with my life. I'm contributing, I'm achieving, I'm living my life, I'm living my purpose. That is what you want to have in your life. You want to have that feeling of fulfillment, because with fulfillment comes real happiness, but fake happiness is conditional, and that's why it never works. But fulfillment is absolutely unconditional to what other people say, to what other people do, to what you have in your life. You can have it no matter where you are. You can have it no matter how much you have achieved. It is something, a feeling that you can internalize, that you can cultivate inside. But that fake happiness is conditional. It is dependent on driving that Lamborghini or having that jet or having that big house. And there's nothing wrong with that. But I would never tie my happiness to my possessions, or what other people think of me, to my fame or something like that, because it never works. It never works. So your happiness, your real happiness, it needs to be unconditional. And that's where self-love comes in. Because the key here, I mean, you want to feel fulfilled, but first you need to feel self-love. I mean, you need to accept yourself fully, unconditionally. And that's what self-love is all about, is loving all of who you are unconditionally, even the flaws and the weaknesses. So if you don't feel self-love, start there. Once you developed self-love, now you can feel real happiness, because you are okay with who you are. You are okay with where you are in life. This is so critically important. We need to accept ourselves fully, and it is easily done by being present in the moment, but of course not always easier. I mean, it's easier said than done. But start with self-love. And down below, there's a self-love playlist, which I highly recommend that you check that out. So we need to start with self-love, and then we can move towards that fulfillment. So here's what fulfillment is. And that is not my equation. I got that from Ed Milet, to give credit where it's due. And it's simply contribution plus achievement. That is simply fulfillment summed up in two words: contribution, achievement. And what I'm suggesting is that you measure your success in life based on two things, just two things. Who did you become and who did you help? Who did you become and who did you help? It has nothing to do with your external possessions or your like credentials or like your title or something like that. Who did you become and who did you help? That's a simple way to measure your success in life, and you can find this easily in this like formula for fulfillment. So achievement is who did you become, and contribution is who did you help. It is as simple as that. And at the end of our lives, we're just going to ask those two things. Who did I become and who did I help? Because life is about feeling joyous and present in the present moment and then helping others to live a great life. And you can do this in so many forms. So many times we feel like, well, my job, it's kind of like boring and it doesn't touch any lives. But that's not true. Anything that is on this planet today can have an impact on other people. And you might have things like, yeah, I'm the street sweeper right here. Well, you're making a difference in people's lives. Maybe they don't see it, maybe they don't like appreciate it, but that doesn't mean that you can't feel fulfilled for being a street sweeper of like an accountant or like a call center agent. You can find meaning and fulfillment in whatever you choose to do. It doesn't matter how much you earn, it doesn't matter your title, it doesn't matter how much like accolades you get. Fulfillment is something that you decide. It is a choice. It is a choice to feel great about yourself. It is a choice to enjoy what you're doing. No matter what you're doing, there's meaning in anything that you do. You just need to find it. That's really important. And then also that you live a life that you're really proud of. I mean, that's what achievement is all about. Achievement is not about like getting a new promotion or getting that thing. It is how do you feel about yourself? How do you feel about the life that you are creating for yourself? And when you feel that sense of pride for the life that you are creating, well, that is unstoppable. That is so much more than just that fake happiness that we so often see. So when you feel that sense of pride, well, your life is going to be very different. So for example, every day I shoot one new video because I love shooting videos. And I have so much pride in that. I love creating, I love expressing myself, and it fills me with pride. It fills me with a feeling like, yeah, I'm doing something meaningful with my life. I'm doing something that is of real value. Because I have that sense of pride, right now I'm feeling pretty, pretty joyful. I'm pretty, pretty present in the moment. And that is something I not always had. I mean, for the first half year in my business, it was all about like, I need to do more, I need to do more, I need to keep up with other people. And I didn't allow myself to feel that joyfulness. I didn't allow myself to be in the present moment because I felt like I need to keep up with everybody else. But that is not real achievement. Real achievement is simply, yes, I'm proud of what I created. I'm proud of the life that I create for myself. I am in charge. I take ownership of my own life. I'm not waiting for anybody else to give it to me, but I'm creating the life I want. I'm creating the life I want. That's real achievement. So we have contribution, achievement, and that equals fulfillment. But life is a journey. So often we treat life as a race, as something that like, yeah, I need to get ahead of everybody else. But who are you competing against? You're not competing against anybody. And the ultimate destination of life, when you think about it, is death. Would you like to be ahead of anybody else on that race? I wouldn't. So life is a journey. It is a journey. A journey of creating the life you want. So you can feel self-love right now. You can feel real happiness in this moment right here, knowing that this is a journey, knowing that you're going to create a better future. I know that. I have a big vision for my life. But I'm also pretty joyful right now because knowing I'm doing the things I need to do to live my life right now and in the future. So much with real happiness has to do with living congruently and focusing on the process of who you are becoming. This is so critically important to understand. Life is a journey that you're on. It is never a destination because the only destination of life is death. And that's not the destination I want to get there quick. Like It can take some time. I'm not in a rush. And that's a real key to feeling more happy, to feeling more fulfilled in life, knowing that your life is not based on those results that you get, on getting ahead of anybody else, because it's not about that. It's about who are you becoming and who can you help. This is really simple, and I suggest that you measure your life success only on those two things. Who do you become and who do you help? And you can help in many different forms. But see, life as a journey, and it is not about how much you do. So often you think like, I need to do so much more and I need to get ahead of anybody else. You can live a life that is pretty happy, pretty joyful, and you're a school teacher or someone, I don't know, but you don't need to have those like outside success. It is not how much you do. Rather, it is how you do it. So you can be a school teacher, but if you're nurturing little children to become amazing human beings, for example, that is a pretty happy life. I mean, if you see it as a craft, if you see it as something that is really meaningful to other people, which like teaching is, well, if you feel it like that, if you do it like that, well, that is a happy life. So it is not about how much you do, but how you do it. And obviously, when you can combine the two of those, well, that's a magic formula. So for example, every day I create a video. And before I did that, I felt like, well, is this going to be exhausting? Is this something that will burn me out? And I had to realize, and I had to try, of course, I had to jump in, and I realized, no, this is fueling my joy. This is fueling my presence. This isn't something that is draining me. Something, work, can only drain you if you're doing work that does not matter to you. That's the real thing. So when we're doing something that we really love, that we enjoy doing, how could that ever drain you? I mean, it is joyful to be here. I am fully present. How could this drain me? How could this take away from my energy? It is fueling my inner joy. It is fueling my energy. So it is about how you do it. And so often when we're trying to achieve more, we sacrifice how we do it to get more of what we do. And that's not the real path to happiness, because when you sacrifice how you do it, feeling joyful, feeling present in the moment, when you make it a quest to be in this moment, and it's not always easy, but when you make it a quest to be in this moment, life starts to feel joyful. It starts to feel magical. So this is really the key. You need to focus on how you do it, knowing that you want to create more, knowing that you want to achieve more, but focus on the moment. Focus on how you can do it right now. That's where happiness really begins. And what we also need to do is we need to let go of outcomes. I already mentioned this, but it is so vitally important. I mean, for example, when I create a video, it is about the process of creating something from scratch. I mean, there's nothing. And then there is something. That is a process of creation. And I'm not like determining the success of a video by how many views it got or by how many subscribers or by how many whatever. I mean, you can measure anything, but that's not what really matters. What really matters is the process of becoming your greater self, of adding value to other people. This is so critically important. So we need to let go of outcomes, and this is so vitally important. We need to understand that the how and the when, we can't tell. We can't tell when our dream is going to happen. We can't tell when we're going to achieve a certain milestone, and we can't tell how it's going to happen. Because if we were to know how and when, well, it wouldn't be the unknown. It wouldn't be something that would be better than what we have right now. So when you can predict how and when something is going to happen exactly, well, that shows us that you're not trying to create something new, that you're not trying to create something that is better than what you already have. So we need to let go of those outcomes, because if we're creating a life that we want to be proud of, we need to create a life that is constantly growing, That is growing, because when you are growing, you feel fulfilled. You feel like I'm moving in the right direction. You feel like that sense of pride. And when you are growing, it means that you can't predict what is going to happen next, because you don't know what is going to happen next. So we need to let go of those outcomes. We need to let go of that need to predict what is going to happen in our lives and just go with the flow. I mean, if you were to go down a river, you could either like try to change the destination of the river, or you just jump in a raft and you go down and see how it takes you. I mean, these are two choices. But if you want to feel real happiness, if you want real fulfillment, you need to let go of those outcomes and do whatever you need to do to create the life you want to live. I'm creating daily videos. That's my style. That's my thing. I love doing it. So I'm focused on how I do it, and I'm focused on the process. I have to learn this. I didn't know this, but this changes how you're showing up every single day. And then lastly, I already mentioned that you need to grow yourself. This is really easy, but you need to grow yourself, because there are only two states in the human conditions: growth or death. Growth or death. That is really simple, but for example, in brain science, we notice your brain is either growing or it is dying. It is either growing or it is dying. So the only two conditions is to either grow yourself or to diminish yourself. There's nothing in between there. So when you want to feel real happiness, well, you're going to make it a quest to become better every single day. Not like I need to be better to feel love or to be like good enough. You're already good enough right now. But you need to have that knowledge of, yeah, I want to be better. I want to show up better. I want to do better. I want to serve better. When you grow yourself, it is almost impossible to not feel fully alive. When you then make it a quest to go into the present moment, that's where your real happiness starts. So I hope this video is really helpful, because it is helpful for me. I had to synthesize what I learned already, so it was really challenging for me. So what I want you to do right now, post down below, what was one insight you had in this video? Was this helpful? Let me know. And down below is the self-love playlist that will help you immensely in feeling like that sense of pride of your life, and feeling like, yeah, I'm good where I am right now, and I feel deserving of what I want in my life. It will help you so much. And other than that, make sure that you smash that subscribe button, hit that notification bell. If you haven't already, then smash that like button so we trigger the YouTube algorithm. And other than that, make sure that you live fully, live openly, and be the leader of your life.